Meet Marjan and Manon. In the chemicals industry, they are working to increase energy efficiency by installing new furnaces, reduce carbon dioxide or CO2 emissions by using solar power, and recycling plastic to help cut waste. Chemicals are key ingredients in pretty much everything most people use every day. T-shirts and trousers, medicines and mattresses, phones and TVs, ships and satellites. But around 3% of all carbon dioxide emissions globally come from the chemicals industry. So, in the Netherlands, Shell Chemicals, as well as the Dutch chemicals industry, are working to limit energy use and cut carbon emissions.
Products from the chemicals industry are used everywhere.
This is Manon Bloemer, director of the Royal Association of the Dutch Chemical Industry, or in Dutch, the VNCI.
Making the chemicals that go into so many of the products that we all use, think of home insulation or solar panels, or even the camera that I'm being filmed on. This requires a huge amount of energy.
And using energy from hydrocarbons produces CO2 emissions, which need to be reduced.
And that's where Shell comes in.
This is Marjan Samson, project developer at Shell Chemicals Park Moerdijk.
Here we make the base chemicals, which are then transported for further processing before they are turned into the day-to-day products every one of us will recognize. Behind me are the cracking furnaces. They break down fractions of crude oil into base chemicals. We're replacing 16 of them with new, more efficient ones. They use less energy and thus help us to reduce CO2 emissions.
But replacing these furnaces is no easy task. They arrive by sea as pre-built sections and need to be delicately transported to Moerdijk. They are then lifted into position by a huge heavy lift crane and connected to the rest of the plant without interrupting production.
Once they're in position and connected, these furnaces recover more heat, which can be reused elsewhere in the process. So we need less fuel.
This will reduce CO2 emissions by 10%, or 240,000 tons a year. That's the annual CO2 emissions of 106,000 cars. And that's not the only trick up Marjan's sleeve.
We have a 27 megawatt solar park here at site, which generates 3% of our electricity consumption. And because it's renewable, it saves 10,000 tons of CO2 every year.
And that's not all.
We take a circular approach to products. So we're building a plant that helps to recycle used plastic into base chemicals.
Switching to low carbon energy and feedstock and improving overall energy efficiency are some of the ways in which the chemicals industry is working to reduce its overall emissions. And I, for one, am happy that my hat and my coat could be made using fewer emissions.